Krishna.
Good morning. How is everyone? I'm again with you with a new story. It's a new day, so there has to be a new story. And today we are taking up Ishwaran, the storyteller. We shall be talking about Mahendra, the supervisor, and Ishwaran, the cook, the storyteller. Okay, tell me, do you believe in ghosts? No. But Mahendra saw something one night. Mahendra ne dekha tha. Ek raat jab Mahendra utha, to usne kuch aisa dekha ki usko sardiyon ki raat mein paseena aa gaya. हम जानेंगे स्टोरी में. लेट्स स्टार्ट द स्टोरी. द स्टोरी वॉज नैरेटेड टू गणेश बाई अ यंग मैन, महेंद्र बाई नेम. ही वॉज अ जूनियर सुपरवाइजर इन अ फर्म विच ऑफर्ड ऑन हायर सुपरवाइजर्स एट वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन साइट्स, फैक्ट्रीज, ब्रिजेस, dams and so on. Mahendra's job was to keep an eye on the activities at work site. He had to keep moving from place to place every now and then as ordered by his head office. From a coal mining area to a railway bridge construction site, from there after a few months to a chemical plant which was coming up somewhere. He was a bachelor. His needs were simple and he was able to adjust himself to all kinds of odd conditions. Whether it was an ill-equipped circuit house or a makeshift canvas tent in the middle of a stone quarry, but one asset he had was his cook, Ishwaran. The cook was quite attached to Mahendra and followed him uncomplainingly wherever he was posted. He cooked for Mahendra, washed his clothes, and chattered away with his master at night. He could weave out endless stories and anecdotes on varied subjects. So boys and girls, देखिए अभी तक हमने जाना कि महेंद्र ने ये कहानी एक युवा गणेश को सुनाई. और ये कहानी है महेंद्र और ईश्वरन. महेंद्र थे सुपरवाइजर और ईश्वरन थे उनके कुक. वो महेंद्र एक ऐसी कंपनी में काम किया करते थे जो सुपरवाइजर्स प्रोवाइड करती थी डिफरेंट वर्क साइट्स के लिए. एंड दिस वाज द रीजन Mahendra had to go from one place to the other, sometimes to the coal mining places, sometimes to a site where a bridge was being constructed, and then after few months jahan ek plant ban raha tha, a chemical plant ban raha tha, wahan jana pad raha tha. Lekin Mahendra bachelor tha, एडजस्ट करने में ज्यादा दिक्कतें नहीं आती थी. वो कहीं भी रह सकता था, कभी किसी सर्किट हाउस में, वो भी वेल इक्विप्ड नहीं, और कभी कभार अगर ठहरना पड़े तो टेंट हाउस में भी रह लेता था, कैनवस के बने हुए टेंट के एक रूम में भी रह लेता था. एक बड़ा पॉजिटिव पर्सन उसके साथ हमेशा रहता था, पॉजिटिव इन द सेंस ही वॉज अटैच्ड टू महेंद्र एंड दिस पर्सन वॉज ईश्वर. लेट्स फाइंड आउट वॉट हैपन्स फर्दर इन द स्टोरी. ईश्वर also had an amazing capacity to produce vegetables and cooking ingredients seemingly out of nowhere in the middle of a desolate landscape with no shops visible for miles around. He would miraculously conjure up the most delicious dishes made with fresh vegetables within an hour of arriving at the zinc seat shelter at a new workplace. Mahendra would be up early in the morning and leave work after breakfast, carrying some prepared food with him. Meanwhile, Ishwaran would tidy up the shed, wash the clothes, have a leisurely bath, pouring several buckets of water over his head, muttering a prayer all the while. It would be lunchtime by then. After eating, he would read for a while before dozing off. The book was usually some popular Tamil thriller running to hundreds of pages. Its imaginative descriptions and narrative flourishes would hold Ishwaran in a thrill. So, students, so far we have read the daily routine at a work site for both Mahendra as well as Ishwaran. हमने देखा कि महेंद्र एक अर्ली बर्ड था, सुबह सुबह जल्दी उठ करके तैयार होकर नाश्ता करके और अपना लंच साथ में लेके महेंद्र चले जाते थे अपने काम पर. ईश्वरन ही यूज्ड टू टाइडी अप द शेड एंड आफ्टर दैट he used to finish up other things, and then of course he had a leisurely bath, pouring several buckets of water over his head, and he used to mutter prayer. So this was the daily routine. Lekin लंच करने के बाद ही हैड अ हैबिट ऑफ रीडिंग बुक्स एंड देन डोजिंग. वो ईश्वरन जो है तमिल थ्रिलर्स पढ़ते थे हंड्रेड्स ऑफ पेजेस, और बड़ा इमेजिनेटिव डिस्क्रिप्शन उनमें होता था. इस तरह से ईश्वरन ऑलवेज वॉज इन अ थ्रिल. देखिए आगे क्या होता है स्टोरी में. His own descriptions were greatly influenced by the Tamil authors that he read. When he was narrating even the smallest of incidents, he would try to work in suspense and a surprise ending into the account. For example, instead of saying that he had come across an uprooted tree on the highway, he would say with eyebrows suitably arched and hands held out in a dramatic gesture, "The road was deserted and I was alone. Suddenly, I spotted something that looked like an enormous bushy beast lying sprawled across the road.
I was half inclined to turn and go back, but as I came closer, I saw that it was a fallen tree with its dry branches spread out.
Mahendra would stretch himself back in his canvas chair and listening to Iswaran's takes uncritically. So we are able to see through that most of the habits of telling stories that Iswaran has developed, it has come from the Tamil thrillers that he used to read. Tamil thrillers, वो जो राइटर्स थे तमिल के, वो जो कहानियां ईश्वरन ने पढ़ी उनकी एक झलक उसकी हर बात बताने में दिखाई देती थी. वही सस्पेंस, वही सरप्राइज ईश्वरन हमेशा प्रोड्यूस कर दिया करता जब भी वो कोई भी इंसिडेंट सुनाता. एग्जांपल के लिए अगर उसे छोटी सी भी बात बतानी हो कि मैं रोड से आ रहा था, हाईवे से पेड़ टूटा पड़ा था, तो वो इस तरह से नहीं बताता था. ईश्वरन वुड से द रोड वॉज डेजर्टेड, आई वॉज अलोन ऑन द रोड एंड आई सॉ अ बिग बीस्ट स्प्रॉल्ड अक्रॉस द रोड. इस तरह से वो कहानी को बताया करता, ये उसका स्टाइल था. और फिर उसका एंडिंग कर दिया करता, जब मैं पास पहुंचा तो मैंने पाया कि वो तो एक पेड़ है. इस तरह की एक और दूसरी कहानी ईश्वरन के द्वारा जो बताई गई थी, आइए आगे पढ़ते हैं. आई एम श्योर यू विल एंजॉय. द प्लेस I came from is famous for timber. Iswaran would begin. There is a richly wooded forest all around. The logs are hauled onto the lorries by elephants. They are huge, well-fed beasts. When they turn wild, even the most experienced mahout is not able to control them. After this prologue, Iswaran would launch into an elaborate anecdote involving an elephant. One day, a tusker escaped from the timber yard and began to roam about, stamping on bushes, tearing up wild creepers and breaking branches at will. You know, sir, how an elephant behaves when it goes wild, when it goes mad. Iswaran would get so caught up in the excitement of his own story that he would get up from the floor and jump about, stamping his feet in emulation of the mad elephant. The elephant reached the outskirts of our town, breaking the fences down like matchsticks. He would continue. It came into the main road and smashed all the stalls selling fruits, mud pots and clothes. People ran helter-skelter in panic. The elephant now entered a school ground where children were playing, breaking through the brick wall. All the boys ran into the classrooms and shut the doors tight. The beast grunted and wandered about, pulling out the football goalpost, tearing down the volleyball net, kicking and flattening the drum capped for water.
and uprooting the shrubs. Meanwhile, all the teachers had climbed up to the terrace of the school building. From there, they helplessly watched the depredations of the elephant. There was not a soul below on the ground. The streets were empty, as if inhabitants of the entire town had suddenly disappeared. I was studying in junior class at the time and was watching the whole drama from the rooftop. I don't know what came over me suddenly. I grabbed a cane from the hands of one of the teachers and ran down the stairs into the room, into the open. The elephant grunted and menacingly swung a branch of a tree which it held in its trunk. It stamped its feet, kicking up a lot of mud and dust. It looked frightening, but I moved slowly towards it, stick in hand. People were watching the scene, hypnotized from nearly housetops. The elephant looked at me red-eyed, ready to rush towards me. It lifted its trunk, trumpeted loudly. At that moment, I moved forward and, mustering all my force, backed up its third toenail on the quick. The beast looked stunned for a moment, then it shivered from head to foot and collapsed. So this was the style of telling stories. This is how Ishwaran used to tell stories. अब देखिए, ईश्वरन ने इस हाथी के बारे में बताया और उससे पहले एक एनेक्डोट भी उसके साथ अटैच कर दिया. सर, क्या आपको पता है जब हाथी पागल हो जाते हैं तो बेस्ट माहौत भी उनको कंट्रोल नहीं कर पाते. और एक ऐसा ही हाथी एक बार हमारे टाउन में घुस गया था. पूरा टाउन खाली हो गया, बच्चों के स्कूल में घुस गया दीवार तोड़कर, और बच्चे भाग गए क्लासरूम्स में, टीचर चढ़ गए छत पे. और ईश्वरन का ऐसा कहना है, पता नहीं कहां से उसने साहस जुटाया और टीचर के हाथ से छड़ छीन लिया और हाथी के थर्ड टो पे एक मारा जोर से, और हाथी पूरा कांपने लगा और गिर गया. इस तरह की कहानियां सुनाने में ईश्वरन को महारत हासिल थी. आपको कैसा लग रहा है? हम यहाँ ईश्वरन की कहानियों को, इस वीडियो को तो बंद कर रहे हैं, लेकिन अगले वीडियो में ईश्वरन के द्वारा सुनाई गई एक और कहानी भी लेकर आएंगे. और स्कूल में पढ़े हुए हाथी का क्या हुआ, ये वहाँ से उठ पाया या नहीं, ये भी बताएंगे. बट बिफोर दैट यू हैव टू वॉच दिस वीडियो ट्वाइस एट लीस्ट, रीड द टेक्स्ट, learn the word meanings and do all the exercises. Promise me, you will be doing all the exercises and word meanings, and soon, very soon in fact, I'll again be with you with the next part of this lesson. Thanks for joining. Thanks a lot.